Oh boy. Hey, fellas.
Well, we got some news for you.
Wait till you hear this.
You know that metal we found in the rocks?
Yeah.
We put it through a bunch of tests, a lot of tests, and we're 100% sure that it is the metal called gallium. And man, I'll tell you, it's some weird stuff. It was morphing into different shapes, changing.
Pulsating. It was beating, it was moving around.
Discovered by a French chemist in 1875, gallium is a soft, silvery metal with a melting point of 85.6 degrees Fahrenheit. It is a byproduct of aluminum and zinc production, but can also be created by smelting. Ideal for carrying high voltages, gallium is commonly used in electronic circuits, semiconductors, and LED panels. Its military applications include communications, radar, and electronic warfare. But it is most sought after for incredibly efficient, high-tech solar panels.
It's real strange because we've got this paradox there. Gallium was only discovered in 1875, and we find it in an Aztec-aged box underwater in a cave. So there's lots of questions we got to answer.
I mean, the process they found out in 1875, didn't they have to smelt it? Didn't they have to work it to get that way?
Yes, they did. You're exactly.
We're talking about 500 years ago.
So they made this stuff, basically.
That's what Eric's talking about.
They had to have some use for it, or else it wouldn't have been down.
Exactly. Yeah. But why, though? Yeah. That's the question.
Yeah.
And who? Was it the Aztecs?
Well, it had to be fairly valuable to them because they went to a lot of trouble to hide it.
I would think so. Yeah.
Yeah, there's no doubt. Something's going on there.
How much more of that stuff is in there?
Oh, there's rocks after rocks. There's tons of rocks.
All the rocks we broke open had it in them.
I don't know where this is going to lead us.
But I got a feeling it's right back into that cavern.
I don't know if anybody got any rest last night.
It's been quite a roller coaster, that's for sure.
Yeah.
We know that the rocks themselves, they're in ore. But what is this gallium doing in the rocks?
It had to have had some value to them back then,
yeah,
in order to go to that much trouble. There's no telling what else is in there.
Yep.
So we know from carbon dating the box is over 500 years old. We know that it contains rocks. The rocks are used as vessels to hold the gallium. Gallium's a rare metal. You know, the Aztecs held their treasure in a cave that had 7 caverns, which is exactly what we have on this property. So you ask me, you know, I want to know what else is down there.
We have 2 miles of these caves, and we hadn't seen 1% of what the hell is in these cave systems.
We've got to fully explore this entire cave system.
Oh, absolutely.
Because we don't know what is hidden in there still. We need to be able to look at every point in that cavern to find treasure. We've been working on this project for about 2 years now, and so we've got some good data we've already done. GPR, LIDAR, you name it. But there's a lot more we can do.
We got to find that dry entrance, and we've got to.
Yep.
So last year, we spent months looking for a dry entrance to the cavern.
Come on, baby.
Where we could hypothetically just walk in and not have to deal with diving.
Oh, yeah.
So we're going to see what we can do to find the dry cavern under there. And we'll drill our own hole, basically creating our own entrance. So when we get in the dry part, we'll be able to explore so much faster and find out what's down there.
I think we can do it. Ultimately, finding this dry entrance is going to be a result of science. I've got a lot of tools at my disposal that will allow me to identify a dry entrance to the cave system on the ranch.
Great. All right, let's do it.
Absolutely.
But we really need to be certain that we're above a dry cavern before we start drilling. Because every time Dwayne calls in a rat hole rig, it costs him another 10 to 20 grand, depending on how deep that hole is. So the first thing I want to do is see what those rocks can tell me. When you're a geologist, you spend a lot of time talking to rocks. Sometimes they talk back. All right, today I took the rocks out that Chad pulled from the box, and I noticed what's called a sucrosic texture to the rock, and that's fancy word for sugary, sort of. I haven't seen anything like this around here. This is a metamorphic rock called quartzite. It was once a sandstone, but then it was subject to heat and pressure, and it sort of just melted it all together. So it's highly mineralized. The great thing about rocks with a sucrosic texture is the pores in these rocks pick up a lot of things that are around them. And so one of the easiest things to look for is radiation. Geiger counter measures radioactivity, and that might be in the rocks. This is a type of rock called quartzite. And so quartzite itself doesn't have any radioactive characteristics. If the Geiger counter picks up radiation, it means that the radiation is coming from the cavern itself. So if these rocks have been sitting in that cave for over 500 years, they're gonna pick up that radioactivity. And so that will tell us a lot about the cave system. And so, yeah. We're getting a little bit there. Seems to be on the outside of this rock, sort of. And you can see the remnants of the gallium right there. And there's nothing there. When I put it to this rock again, that's definitely radioactivity. I think that could be significant. I'm going to call in Dwayne. Dwayne, do you copy? Over.
Hey, what's going on?
So I took out some of these rocks.
Right.
And I got the Geiger counter out. You hear that?
It's picking some up, isn't it?
It's picking up trace amounts of radioactivity.
Wow.
It certainly isn't enough to harm you from a health standpoint.
Right.
You know, I don't know if I'd want to be carrying that around in my pocket for the rest of my life, but
yeah.
Now when we try it on the gallium, there's nothing. It's coming from the rock. So think of it this way. You take a rock that has absolutely no radiation in it. You take it, you stick it next to a nuclear reactor, such as Chernobyl. So when you pick up that rock, it'll have all sorts of radioactivity in it. And that's what's happened here. This could be huge for us, finding a better way to explore that cavern. Oftentimes in cave systems, caves follow faults. It's a weakness in the Earth's crust, basically.
Okay.
And radioactivity tends to find that weak zone. Radionuclides will follow fault zones.
Oh, really?
Okay. Yeah. So the idea here is if we find the radioactivity that's seeping from the ground, we find the fault and potentially the dry entrance to the cave system.
That's a heck of a plan there.
It's
good.
It's worth a shot, right?
Oh, yeah. Wow. Our ace in the hole is Eric. If Eric can narrow down this search to just a few acres, it's huge. We don't want to tear this whole place up. We just need to find a way to detect the dry part of the cavern and then drill a hole and make an entrance to the cavern so that we can explore it. And you can bet your ass we'll use every trick in the book to find it.